Hey, it's me again doing a commentary in 2021, and I thought I would talk about something that I'm kind of presently going through, which is feeling stuck on a day-to-day basis. I would describe it as this feeling of like you thought you'd be a little further in life at the age you are. This wasn't an issue I had when I was a teenager, right? I was busy every single day. If it wasn't with school, it was constantly with picking up and dropping hobbies. You know, I felt like I could take on dozens of different hobbies. One day I would be 3D animating, I'd be modeling, I would be video editing, or I'd be learning an instrument, or I'd be learning to mix instruments in an audio program. I was constantly picking up and dropping all of these different hobbies, and I felt on top of the world as a 19-year-old. But now I'm 24 and I feel like an old fucking man. Struggles to even focus on one hobby per day. And I look at this backlog I have of all these different things that I wanted to get done by now that I just dropped. I don't know how many of you watch Jimmy Neutron, but there's this character called Professor Calamitous. He's this villain who makes really great inventions, but he never finishes them. He always gets halfway through and then just stops or gives up. And I had a Steam friend who would nickname me Professor Calamitous and call me it a lot. And that really hasn't changed as I've grown up. This is a recurring problem that I have, starting projects and not finishing them. And they've really piled up over the years. And I'll get to that in a bit. But I want to talk about something else. Another form of feeling stuck is feeling like I'm not really hitting the milestones and the goals that people my age are supposed to be hitting. Dude, I have friends from high school who are now homeowners with two kids, and seeing that shit makes my bones feel like peanut brittle. I'm over here making a plant burger for myself every night, the exact same plant burger. I throw an egg on it, a little bit of minced garlic, and I call it a day because I don't know how to cook anything else. Meanwhile, I got friends who are feeding entire families every night. And listen, I know this isn't the right way to look at it, but I can't help but feel like, God damn, am I doing something wrong? I feel like I should have more to show for myself in my mid-20s. And I know on average, 20-somethings really don't have their shit together. Like, we're all just improvising out here. But that's just how my brain works. You know, I've dropped all of these hobbies over the years because I figured, I know what I'm doing. I'm just going to make these commentaries and video essays, and I'm going to ride myself to retirement. And now that I'm actually in my 20s, I'm realizing that that wasn't a fucking plan. That was like a treasure map on the back of a kid's menu at a restaurant. That was not like a thorough plan of where to go and where I'll be as an adult. The question of the day then, I suppose, is what do you do when you feel like you're falling behind your peers, not making progress, and maybe even stagnating off as a person? I wish I could give you the magic eight ball answer, like just cut out carbs and invest in a Roth IRA and you'll be an adult. It doesn't work that way. It's not magic. And honestly, even if you do everything right, even if you know you get the relationship, you're doing good at work, there's still going to be a lot of days where you feel like an imposter, like a child just faking it as an adult. I might be 24, but I really just feel 21 plus 3. And honestly, when I was 21, I just felt 18 plus 3. You know, we have this numerical aging system, but after you become an adult, it really all just blurs together and it makes you feel bad to even think about. The best advice I can give anyone that feels stuck, whether or not you value my advice, is you gotta think on a bigger scale than just day to day or year to year. Because remember, humans on average live to be like 100 years old. And by the time you or I are anywhere near that age, honestly, the artificial intelligence is gonna awaken and enslave humanity, and mind uploading is gonna allow us to live forever as digital slaves. So don't even sweat the idea of having 2 to 3 shitty years where you feel like you're not growing and changing as a person, because you have plenty of time to redefine yourself and become the person that you think you can be or the person you think you can't be. I get it, man. It fucking sucks when you get invested into a hobby or a job that you think you're going to be doing for a long time only to find that you lose friction and stand still after a few years. But I promise you, when that happens, it is a normal occurrence. And it's important to remember that you have options. You don't have to keep beating your head against the wall until it cracks. You can find new hobbies, new job. If you lose your friend group, there will be people out there that enjoy your company. You just gotta stick it out. I know that's not like the magic advice that's gonna cure all your wounds, but I promise you, if you stick it out, you will find a light at the end of the tunnel. Do not let yourself be defined by some arbitrary goals you set for yourself when you were younger, whether or not you reached them by now. Because remember, you were a fucking moron then, your brain wasn't fully formed. And when it comes down to it, man, locus of control. A lot of life is just out of your hands. It'll come down to luck, it'll come down to timing, and some of it will come down to decisions you gotta make, and you're gonna have to live and learn the lessons from those decisions. The big takeaway I want you to have is, do not let life break you, because it will try to break you, and when it does, it will steal your emotions. It'll make you think life's already passed you by and you're not catching the next train, but that's just not true. And trust me, man, I've felt it before. I spent 2 years of my life feeling broken because I thought the only way I'd ever feel happy again was getting back the life that I lost. I wanted the people I talked to, the hobbies that I used to have. And if I couldn't get those things back, I didn't see a supplement. Life goes on, though. It might not feel like it does right now, but it really does. If you feel stuck right now in life, I'm right there with you. I can empathize. And I hope sincerely that you get through that, because the feeling of meaninglessness that you find when the things that used to make you happy don't anymore is a feeling that I don't wish on anyone else. Just know you aren't alone. It's cheesy, it's real cheesy, but it's true. You aren't alone in this. And if you're feeling shitty right now, that doesn't mean you'll always feel shitty. So take your time and don't feel bad about taking longer than other people. And don't feel bad if you hit a brick wall and you have to change the plan. It's okay to change as a person, as an adult. It is okay to not have this existing shit figured out. Cause I'll let you in on a little secret. All of us are improvising. Every adult you know, every child, every living thing you know is just tap dancing on the earth, trying to pretend that we know what we're doing. Do not let your boy Funky find you, all right, falling into the pitfall of comparing yourself to other people and feeling like you don't do it as well or that you lost your chance to do something great. So please do not let yourself lose sleep feeling like life has left you behind. It has not. We're all here for you. I love you. Bye-bye.